Señor Presidente,
Mr. Chairman, I would like to begin by expressing my sincere congratulations to you on your election to the chair of this session of the Conference of the States Parties, and I can guarantee that my delegation shall lend you its full support. I would also like to take this opportunity to express my gratitude to Ambassador Paul, or to Director General Ahmed Umsusu. His capable management of all of the issues on the agenda has shown once again that he always works with the States Parties in the spirit of transparency and close cooperation. This is his third CSP, and I would like to express to the Director General the full support of Uruguay for the continued success of his work. Mr. Chairman, Uruguay believes that the Convention is an epitome of excellence when it comes to multilateral mechanisms for disarmament and non-proliferation. It is a very useful tool for achieving international peace and security. Therefore, Uruguay remains committed to the principles and aims of the Convention. Paradoxically, the OPCW might become a victim of its own success, for it has nearly succeeded in achieving its prime objective. And so there will have to be some changes in the future in its institutional structure and in its operational structure. At the last CSP, the delegation of Uruguay stressed the growing and firm support of the entire international community to the OPCW. The OPCW indeed has a peerless record when it comes to multilateral mechanisms for disarmament and non-proliferation, especially when it comes to non-proliferation of weapons of mass destruction. This is perhaps a unique contribution, and it's certainly a highly significant contribution to the work that the international community is engaged in, because if we look at what's going on in nuclear and bacteriological disarmament, there's a patent lack of progress. In this connection, it behooves us to remember that the Convention of 1992 is still the only single international multilateral instrument that bans, without distinctions, an entire category of weapons of mass destruction under international control. And therefore, the Convention can continue to make a useful and critical contribution to the strengthening of peace and international security. However, when the process of the complete destruction of declared chemical weapons has reached an end, the activity of the organization might actually start to taper off, especially when it comes to inspections. And for this reason, the OPCW has already entered what we call the transition phase, following 15 years after the entry into force of the Convention. During these 15 years, three-fourths of the declared stockpiles and the overwhelming majority of production facilities have been either dismantled or converted for peaceful purposes. So in simple words, the central and topical issue facing the organization today is how the organization can continue carrying out its mission in a context with changing challenges and a completely different international outlook compared to 1992. We are still facing challenges in four main areas. First, the emergence of new chemical agents that are not included in the schedules of the Convention. Secondly, the use of incapacitating agents under certain circumstances. Third, innovations in chemistry to satisfy the needs of economic development, expansion of agriculture, and improvements in public health. And lastly, the necessity to take measures in order to implement Resolution 1540 of the UN Security Council in 2004, which comprises measures in order to keep non-state agents from getting their hands on the means to manufacture, transfer, or use nuclear, chemical, or biological weapons, or their delivery systems. Mr. Chairman, the Convention has already been ratified by 188 countries, and that is quite an accomplishment, but complete universality is still one of the things that we have to achieve. And actually, universality will probably hinge mainly on what is going on in those countries that are not States Party yet. I think that we should move forward in a patient manner, constantly taking each case on its own merits and taking advantage of any opportunity in order to stress once again that there's no justification for a state to choose the path of chemical holocaust. Perhaps the main reason why the OPCW has been so successful is and shall be the credibility of its verification regime, as well as the shared trust amongst member states when it comes to our common goal, that is establishing a world free from chemical weapons. In this connection, we have seen enormous strides made in verification. However, even though at national level a lot of progress has been made in implementing national legislation and administrative measures, there's still a lot more to be done when it comes to cooperation in each region. Mr. Chairman, the delegation of Uruguay would lend its support to the proposed budget presented by the Director General and supported by the 70th EC. It certainly represents a sincere effort to strengthen in a balanced way the fundamental pillars of the Convention, i.e. verification, cooperation, assistance and protection. We hope that the establishment of a new division on policy and strategy will continue to help the Director General carry out his tasks and face the challenges that the organization is going to contend with in the future. From this standpoint, Uruguay lends its support to the strengthening mechanisms for activities and programs undertaken by the Technical Secretariat for the promotion of peaceful uses of chemistry. As further testimony to our support of Article 11 activities, Uruguay was the host country of a workshop that had 33 high-ranking officials from governments of the region, along with experts, academics, researchers, and representatives from the industry. And it was an excellent opportunity to pinpoint the most efficient means and measures that can be taken in order to continue strengthening the programs that are linked to international cooperation and chemical security and safety. The meeting in Montevideo gave rise to a series of recommendations, and we hope that these recommendations can be taken on board by the Secretariat and also by the by Pakistan, who's facilitating the debate on this, so that other regions can also chip in to ensure further and greater implementation of Article 11 activities. Mr. Chairman, we certainly recognize the need to approach the work at this conference as well as the third review conference in a spirit of building a necessary consensus in order to ensure that there is a free exchange of ideas and experiences. We also believe that the Convention has value that go beyond the provisions contained in the articles of the Convention. We believe that the Convention establishes an entire system in which the sum of the parts, or the whole, is greater than the sum of the parts. And it's in this context that my country would like to express its willingness to continue cooperating with all of the states parties of the OPCW and with the TS. We would like to actually establish a regional center for training, outreach, information, in order to help people in our country or in cooperation with other countries of the region to raise awareness about chemical weapons and what can be done to fight against chemical weapons. Lastly, we would like to welcome the restoration of geographical balance in the upper echelons of the Technical Secretariat. We would like to bid a warm welcome to the new legal advisor, Alberto Rojas from Argentina, and the director of the Inspectorate, Marcelo Costa of Brazil. We're sure that their experience and their vast knowledge will help the Technical Secretariat carry out its work successfully. We would also like to take this opportunity to greet Director Konstantin Gravilov and Director Mark Alban. For quite some time now, they've been providing us with support in the policymaking organs and in cooperation and assistance to states parties. We would hope that this declaration could be included as an official document of the 17th CSP. Thank you very much.